In this video, I'm going to address a very common question presented by one of our subscribers, and this applies to many people, especially during this pandemic. This is relating to how do you extend your non-immigrant status from inside the United States without leaving. Watch this video and I'll see you on the other side. In this video, I'm going to address a very common question that I'm getting from quite a few of our subscribers, and this pertains to how do you extend your status of your non-immigrant visa inside the United States without leaving, because consulates and embassies are still closed in most of the world. This question pertains to an E2 investor visa. How do you extend your investor visa without leaving the United States? So make sure you stay and watch this video, because I'm explaining to you a few tricks and also a few things to be aware of, especially in these crazy times. Before we start, if you're here for the first time, make sure to subscribe to our channel, click that bell to be notified for any new videos that we release, and also click that big like so YouTube will share the video with people just like you. My name is Jacob Sapochnik, and I'm an immigration attorney located in San Diego, California. And we help clients all over the world and all over the United States to achieve their American dream. So let's talk about visa extensions. Hi, Jacob. I'm an E2 visa holder, and I usually go back to Germany to extend my visa. Because of COVID-19, the travel bans, and all these other restrictions, I'm scared and I don't want to go back. How do I extend my immigration status from inside the United States, and for how long will this extension be good for? This is an excellent question, and again, we get quite a few of the similar questions, and whether, in this case, the person is on an investor visa. And typically those investor visas, as you know, when you apply for an E2 visa, typically you need to apply for the visa directly at the US embassy in your home country. The E2 visa is a great visa for people that are looking to start a small business as an investor, specifically coming from a treaty country. There's a list of treaty countries that qualify for the E2 visa. We've done quite a few E2 visa YouTube videos, and I'm gonna link a few of them in the description of this video. But in this particular video, we'll talk about the purpose and how you actually extend it. Remember, right now, E2 visas are very, very popular because of the economy, because of the shifts in the economy. There are a lot of opportunities for real estate, getting leases, cheap leases, and a lot of landlords are eagerly waiting for foreign investors who are coming to the United States. So in the past, of course, it was quite difficult for investors who don't have U.S. credit to apply and get lease and spaces to be able to start businesses. But right now, it's definitely much more, it's easier, and they're accommodating. And we're definitely encouraging people that are watching this video, if you're looking to start your E2 visa, if you want to start a business in the United States, now is a great time to do so. But what if you're already in the United States, like in this question, you already have your E2 visa, and typically you can only extend it in 2 years increments. So if you apply for the E2 visa at the US Embassy, typically they're going to give you a visa for 3 up to 5 years. But when you come to the United States, your permit to stay, also known as the I-94, is only issued for 2 years at a time. You can only stay for 2 years at a time. So even if you have a 5-year visa and your permit to stay, your status to stay expired after 2 years, you have to file for your extension from inside the United States. So how do you do this? So typically, you will have to obviously prepare all the documents to show that your E2 visa is still working. So you have to have your tax returns, updated business plan, your bank accounts, your list of employees, all the documents that you need to show that the business continues to run, that it's still going forward, and make sure that the business plan is updated once again for 5 years in the future. Even though you're going to get your extension for 2 years, you still have to have all the documents to show that you have a viable business and that you're able to extend your E2 visa. Now remember, some E2 visa applicants tried to apply for the EIDL loan from inside the United States in the beginning, in March and April. In the beginning, when the EIDL loans were available, they were also, some banks issued them to E2 visa holders. Now remember, this is still considered to be a loan, and so it's not a pure investment. So even if you got your EIDL loan as an E2 visa holder, that alone is not considered to be as an extra investment. We can show that you're using it to build your business, but they still want to see that you have your actual funds or some sort of income or business growth to be able to show that your business is doing good and you're able to stay in the United States. As of late May to this day right now, I don't think that EIDL loans are no longer available for E2 visa holders. Quite a few of our clients who tried to apply were declined, but in the early days of this loan, a few visa, E2 visa holders were actually able to get it. So be careful how you use that loan in the calculation of your business as you apply for an extension. But once you have all your docs, everything is ready, you'll need to file form I-129, just like you file any other work visa with the USCIS. You'll be able to put all the all the information on the form. There's a specific rider for an E2 with the I-129, make sure you complete that as well. And you file this with the appropriate service center, depending on where you live. And as you know right now, visas are available for premium processing, so you can pay an additional $1,400 and you'll be able to get your results in 2 weeks or less. And the idea behind it is that if you expedite your case, then you'll know for sure if you have your extension, and it will give you the peace of mind that you need to be able to stay in the US for another two years. Remember, if you have dependents, those dependents will also need to be joined in this application. We have quite a few people that filed their extensions, but they forgot to add their dependents, because when you apply for the visa at the US Embassy, it's all coming in one package. But if you do it from inside the US, you have to make sure you add the I-539, the petition for change of extension of status for your dependents as well. They need to be included. Therefore, there's an extra fee for them as well. Some of these petitions require biometrics, but now due to the pandemic, USCIS will reuse previous fingerprints, or if they need fingerprints, they'll let you know as well. So make sure not to forget your dependents as well when you file for the extension of status inside the United States. Once you file your E2, even if you file premium processing, they may, unlike the US Embassy, they may request more evidence. It's very common to request for more evidence, and they usually give you a deadline. Right now, during the pandemic days, this deadline is extended by 60 days. So that's good. So you have extra time to respond. Typically, a lot of these cases do get requests for evidence just because the government is more strict. So make sure that you file the application correctly from the beginning to try to avoid getting the request for evidence or minimize the amount of evidence they may require from you. But if you do everything correctly, you should be getting your approval within 2 weeks, and then that approval will carry you on for 2 years. It's an I-94, allows you to continue to work and grow your business in the United States. Our recommendation is that when things get back into normal and you can travel again, you should go back to your home country and get a proper visa and your passport, so it allows you to go back and forth and travel when, of course, the borders will be open. So hopefully this information was helpful. If any questions, post them in the comments below. If you're here for the first time, subscribe to our channel, give us the big like, so YouTube also will share this video with more people just like you. Don't forget, in the description of this video, we have a link to our private membership, Immigration U Inner Circle. Make sure you join that membership. This is a place where you can continue to follow immigration trends, get questions answered, get second opinions, and seriously go through the immigration process confidently, knowing you have a trusted guide with you. So I encourage you to check out our Inner Circle private membership. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.